Hey everyone, welcome back to Munyal Media. Hey y'all, so I hope you're all having a great day. So in this video, I'm going to tell you a little bit about our stopover in Sharjah. We were heading to Doha, not to see the World Cup, not to see any of the soccer games, but we were there during World Cup time. So we were in the vibes and in the thick of all the World Cup energy. Anyway, we had a bad experience with Air Arabia. Air Arabia was the airline that took us to Doha. And as a result, we found ourselves spending the night in Sharjah. And we stayed at this hotel called Central Hotel. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about our stay at the hotel and how that was before we caught our flight the next morning to Doha. So I really like this hotel. I found it to be neat, clean. You know, if you've been following me here, watching some of my videos, you realize that cleanliness is very important to me, extremely important actually. So here I'm just showing you some of the storage space in the closets. Then they had a kettle, so you can boil water, make tea. That's also very important to me. Cleanliness, tea. The bathroom was bright, it was clean, you know, nice shower experience. Makeup remover pads if anyone needs, you know, knickknacks like that, Q-tips, things like that if you forget to travel with them. So here I am in the lobby. We're about to get into the elevator, so you can see it's a very large, long lobby. So here we are getting into the elevator. Okay, so I realized I just made a mistake. That's not the lobby, that's the corridor. So as we go down in the elevator now you're going to see the lobby. So here is the lobby. Here's the spacious. It's also very large and spacious. Well decorated, green sofas. So here we are going to the buffet for dinner. So here is their menu. I just took this off Google to help those of you who like to travel, who are looking for somewhere to spend the night, especially if you have a layover or something like that. So there's a menu from Google. Here is a view of the dining room. Again, very large dining room. So as you can see, this hotel lobby has very high ceilings. Here's the buffet dinner, a lot of food on the buffet. From what I remember, it was a good buffet. The food was really good. So here you see the guy at the fish counter doing fresh fish. Look how big this fish is. Wow. So this is the next morning before the flight. I ordered room service for breakfast. The breakfast was really good. So the lady who received my order over the phone, she was very good, very professional. However, the kitchen did not pay attention when she was communicating my order to them, because when the food was sent up, there were a couple of mistakes. So I had to call back down, and that was a bit annoying. And then they had to fix the order, send it back up again. So that was the only annoying part. The kitchen was not so attentive, and especially because it's like first you contact her, then she communicates your order to the kitchen. So it wasn't a smooth process in that sense. But otherwise, you know, the breakfast was really good. The hotel service was great. The staff were friendly. There was this Filipino man who works at the front desk at the reception. He was very friendly. I wish I could remember his name, so then I could include his name and give him a nice review online. But I forget his name. But he was very friendly and made our stay even more enjoyable. So all in all, I thought it was a great hotel. Thank you to the staff there. Very professional, very well trained. And on to the airport we go. As you know from my other vlogs, I'm always raving about the streets. It seems like my whole trip I was raving about the streets and the cleanliness and the beautiful design and the public spaces. So here's just another example. As we drove to the airport, you can see how the streets are so nicely lined by trees, by manicured lawns. I loved it. Very clean. I appreciate that cleanliness, beauty, the pride they take in aesthetics and making the physical spaces, the physical space in which they inhabit, in making that space beautiful. There's something to be said about that. And it just shows the value for public spaces, for design, for public wellness, you know, for visual stimulation and for visual beauty. So here we are arriving at the airport, about to catch our flight to Doha. And like I said, unfortunately, we didn't have a good experience with Air Arabia. It had to do with the ticketing staff and issues around the Hayya card to get into Doha. The staff on the plane on board, they were totally fine, but it had to do with the ticketing staff, and then the ticket price kept going up and up and up, and they said they would hold, they would guarantee a certain price for us, and then they didn't, and then it kept going up, and then they were saying they were going to hold a certain price, then the price was never held. So it became very dramatic, very stressful. You know, fortunately, we found our way to Doha. The next day, we should have gone the day prior, but because of all those complications, so I wasn't impressed. And the staff, the ticketing staff said one thing, and then, you know, person B said another thing. But thank God, we managed to get to Doha. So here we are, arrivals, Doha airport. We had just stepped out of the airport. You can see all of the World Cup signage and symbols everywhere. The night was young. The night felt very young. It was warm, so the heat was great. I love heat because I'm a person of the sun. If you know what I'm saying, you know what I'm saying. People of the sun. So here we are driving through the night, driving on the streets, on the way to the hotel. This is a hotel. It's called the Town Hotel. So more on the hotel later, but after we put down our bags, we went to explore a little bit. So here's one of the main areas. This place was called SOUQ WAQIF, SOUQ WAQIF. And it was the main, or one of the main sites for the World Cup fans to hang out, because as you're about to see, there are a lot of cafes and restaurants in this area. So it was very busy. It was jam-packed when we arrived that night. So here you can see at the entrance, there's an arch. You see this little archway, and it says FIFA World Cup Qatar 2022. So everyone was going there just to partake in the nighttime festive energy. So here we are walking through the souk. Exploring Islam. So I love this. I thought it was just great. And there were people from everywhere, from all over the world. All of the continents were represented. So look how the souk was constructed in this very beautiful open air style. So I quite like it. What do you guys think of this? Isn't it quite nice? Like this open air style, you have restaurants and cafes to both sides. You just walk through freely. I mean, granted, it was very busy then, but imagine when it's less busy. You can just stroll through, pop into whichever cafe you like, have a cup of tea. So I read something online that this architectural style is like the 1930s Qatari architectural style. So it's quite neat. It's quite neat. And so there was a late night art exhibit happening in there. There were signs pointing to the right to an art exhibit. So very creative, you know, because there were different nighttime activities. So some were at cafes, some were at restaurants. But if you wanted to walk through, visit the art exhibit, it really makes the night dynamic and vibrant, giving people the option to partake in different activities, all of which were family friendly. I always stress that in a lot of these vlogs too. This is one thing I liked about visiting the Gulf region. I found it to be very family friendly. So now let's jump to the hotel. It was called the Town Hotel. It was a small hotel in town. I guess you could call it a boutique hotel. Because most hotels were booked out during the World Cup, it was really hard to find hotels. So when we did our search, this is what we were able to find. To begin with the positives, the breakfast was great. You can see the dining area was bright and open. The staff were very friendly, the front desk staff, very helpful, very friendly. So kudos to them. I thank them for a great stay. So as you can see, the swimming pool is on the roof and offers a nice panoramic view of the city. The one thing I would like the managers to improve are the rooms. While the rooms are big and, you know, the bathroom is nice and clean, but as you can see, it's carpeted. So my suggestion to the managers would be to get rid of the carpet, you know, just when you think of dust absorption and things like that. But otherwise, you can see large windows. they put some painting to try to, you know, give us some decoration in there. It's quite nice. I would just say get rid of the carpets. All in all, we had a great stay there, and I'll come back again to share some more footage from the hotel later on in the video. So stay with me, friends. So this is where we had dinner, Al-MOURJAN Restaurant, which we soon discovered is a chain there in Doha. It's a restaurant chain. I believe it's Lebanese. The food was really good. So here I'm just showing you a little bit of the restaurant. Again, very neat, clean, bright, good food, nice soup, lentil soup. I like lentil soup. I like salad. Very substantial portions too. So it was a nice dinner.
Where's the camera? Hey, hey.
It's outstanding with the color.
drivers a sense of the size of the elevator.
Enjoying the pool, sitting by the pool at the top of the building, seeing the entire city spread out.
Doha.
Doha, Qatar.